Hello everybody, and welcome to today's Tinkershop tutorial. My name is Melissa from the Innisfil Idea Lab and Library. In today's tutorial, you will learn how to use Inkscape and InkStitch to design for the embroidery machine. Before we begin, you will need to download Inkscape and the extension InkStitch from www.inkscape.org. Once these programs have been downloaded and installed onto your computer, we can now begin. When you open Inkscape, you will have a rectangular canvas located in the center of your screen. This canvas is where we will do all of our design work during today's tutorial. In order to design for the embroidery machine, we must size the canvas to fit the hoops for the embroidery machine. Our largest hoop is 4 inches by 4 inches. To change the size of our document, we are going to go to File in the top left-hand corner of the screen and select Document Properties from the menu that appears. I'm just going to move this menu over so we can all see it. The first thing we need to do is change our units of measurement. Right now, the program is measuring in millimeters, but for our purposes, we are going to measure in inches. Change your display units from millimeters to IN, which is inches. We're also going to do that for our units. Now that I've changed the unit of measurement, I need to change the measurement for my width and my height. We are going to set both of those numbers at 4 inches. You should notice on the screen that your canvas size has now changed to 4 inches by 4 inches. Close the Document Properties window by clicking the X located in the top right-hand corner. To make it easier when designing, we can zoom in and out of our document. Use the plus sign on your screen to zoom in and the minus sign on your screen to zoom out. Now that my canvas size is set, it's time to import my first image. We are going to be using a web browser today to search the internet. I'm going to be using Google Chrome, but you can use whatever browser works the best for you. You could use Internet Explorer or Firefox. Left-click on your selected browser to begin. Once it is loaded, we are going to search for vector designs. These could also be searched by using silhouettes or outlines of images. I'm going to search for a rabbit silhouette vector. Once you've entered in your search terms, hit enter on your keyboard. This will bring up all of the images that are available to use. I'm going to left click on images so that all I see are picture files. When designing for the embroidery machine, we want simple black and white images. Things with significant amount of details or pieces are going to be a challenge for the embroidery machine. I'm going to choose this rabbit right here. Left click on your design to make it bigger. Once it's enlarged, it is time to either save or copy your image. To do this, you are going to right-click on the image and select either Save Image As or Copy Image from the menu. If you select Save Image As, a second window will appear. This will allow you to rename your file. I'm going to name mine Rabbit and select Save from the bottom menu. This will place your item that you are saving on the desktop of your computer, making it easier to find later. You can also select Copy Image to copy and paste the image into Inkscape. Select Inkscape from the bottom menu. It looks similar to a little mountain. This will reopen your canvas and workspace. If you went with the copy and paste option, you are going to right-click on your mouse and select paste from the menu. Your image should appear on your screen. If you chose to save your image, you are going to go up to File in the top left-hand corner and select Import from the menu. Find your image. There's mine, it's named Rabbit. Left-click on the image and select Open. When this menu appears, we are always going to select OK. Now, for our purposes today, I only need one copy of my rabbit. I'm going to get rid of the second one. I currently have a JPEG image located on my screen, but unfortunately, the embroidery machine can't read this type of file. We need to convert it to a vector image. To do this, we are going to select Path from the top menu options. Left-click on Path, and select the third option, Trace Bitmap. This will cause a window to pop out of your screen. Select Live Preview from the options. You should be able to see your image in the preview window, and click OK. We can now close the Trace Bitmap window by clicking the little X in the top right-hand corner. I now have two images on my screen, a JPEG and a vector image. I'm going to separate these two images. Place your mouse in the center of the image, hold down the left button on your mouse, and drag the image to the side. This will now allow you to see both images on your screen. Double-click on the image, and you should see all of these node points. The node points let us know that this is the image we want to keep. This is our vector image. If I was to double click on the other image on the screen, you will notice that nothing happens. This is our vector image and the one that we are going to delete. Use your Move tool located in the top left-hand corner of your screen to select the image and delete it. To delete your image, right-click on your mouse and select Delete from the menu options. I now need to move my vector image onto my canvas. Move your cursor on top of the image, left-click on your mouse, and drag your image onto the screen. You will also notice that there are some arrows located around your image. These will allow you to size your image either bigger or smaller. If you would like your image to stay proportionate while sizing, hold the control button on your keyboard. This will allow it to stay proportionate. Once you are happy with the size of your image, we are going to add some text. Our text tool is located on the left-hand side of our screen and is represented by a capital letter A. Left-click on the button to change your tool to the text tool. Bring your cursor back onto your canvas and left-click. You should now see a flashing cursor on the screen. This will allow us to type. I'm going to type the word hop, hop, hop for my bunny. I'm going to go back to my Move tool in order to resize my text. I'm going to make it a lot bigger and move it to the center of my screen. Now it's time to convert your file to an embroidery file. Using your cursor, left-click on your rabbit so that the software knows which item you are changing first. Go up to the top of the screen and select the extensions option, find InkStitch, and we are going to be using the simulate tool. Left click on simulate. This can take a minute or two depending on the image that you have selected. When it's ready, it will begin drawing a simulation of your item. This shows you how the embroidery machine will embroider the picture you have selected. To speed it up, you can select the arrow at the bottom of the screen and drag it across the screen to see your simulation. Perfect. I now know that my rabbit is ready to go. Select quit at the bottom of the screen to close this window. I now need to do the same thing for my font. Left click on your words and select path from the top of the screen. We must take this text and convert it to a path in order for the embroidery machine to read the file. Select object to path. We are now going to choose the extensions tab. Select InkStitch and go down to simulate. Once our simulation has started, we can again see how the embroidery machine is going to embroider our words. Drag the arrow at the bottom of the screen across to speed up this process. Perfect, our text is ready to go. Select quit from the bottom menu. Now is our final chance to position our words and our image in our canvas. I'm going to move my bunny to the very bottom, and I'm going to make my words even bigger. Once you are happy with how your design looks, it's time to save the file. Using your cursor, click on File in the top left-hand corner of your screen and select Save As. You will now need to name this file in order to find it. I'm going to call mine Rabbit. Select Save to save your file. We are also going to save a second type of file called a DST. This type of file can be used on the embroidery machine. Move your cursor back to File, select Save As, and this time, instead of saving it as an Inkscape SVG, select a DST, which is an InkStitch Tajma Embroidery Format. We are now going to click Save again. Both of our files have now been saved to the desktop of our computer and are ready to be used with the embroidery machine at the Innisfil Idea Lab and Library. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial. We look forward to seeing you again soon. Have a wonderful day.